With me from SNU on the line this morning, I'm joined by Anthony Coombs. Anthony, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
You've had a trading update from February through to this week, Anthony. Across the board, the business doing well here. Advantage in particular, profits up on last year.
Yeah, well, we're very pleased. Obviously, our profitability is up on last year. But more important, or as important, of course, is the underlying fundamentals of the business. I mean, debt quality is improving at Advantage in the way that we hoped. I mean, our collections are about 6% up on last year, and on receivables up about 3%. So there is improvement, and our risk-adjusted yield has improved as well. So the kind of measures that we've taken last year in terms of slightly tightened underwriting in the light of current, so slightly uncertain economic climate, have started to bear fruit. And equally important, over the last 2 months, we've seen a huge increase in both applications and a significant increase in transactions with Advantage. So we're very pleased about that.
Why do you think you've seen this big increase in customer numbers?
Well, I think it's possibly because people are gravitating towards our area of the market. In other words, slightly better value cars, particularly given the fact that used cars of, say, 3 to 5 years old, which is what we specialize in, actually offer better value and are more reliable than ever before. People are looking for economy, and as a result, they're coming to us rather than going necessarily for the new car with big depreciation. And you can see that in the overall statistics. The used car market, and particularly the used car finance market, is holding up very well and still slightly increasing on last year, whilst the new car market is actually down on last year. So I think we're seeing some benefits from that.
And impairments, you've seen some improvement there?
Yes, we are. I mean, the obviously it's a big ship now, and in order to be able to turn the ship, it does take some time. But in terms of new customer quality, in terms of the early signs that we get, and obviously we track these by, you know, a huge number of measurables, we're seeing the significant improvement in the quality of the customers, and that's only right, because ultimately our business is a lending one, and it depends on the quality of the loan book.
How are things at Aspen Finance?
Again, very promising. I mean, I've just learned this morning actually that our loan book we know that the loan book is 22 million, but actually I learned this morning that our pipeline, as we call it, our firm pipeline of deals, is at a record level. And I think, again, that's because people are looking for economy. I mean, you know, the new housing market is patchy, you know, very poor in the southeast, generally a little bit better in the Midlands, but slightly patchy. So what people are doing, they're doing refurbishments, and refurbishments is the field that we're in. So we're very confident about that, and we think that the Aspen property business will make the kind of profits we've budgeted for them this year.
So a strong performance here. What are your expectations for the remainder of 2019?
Andrew, if I knew that, I mean, obviously we're going to hit budget. That's my main aim, and you know we're going to underpromise and hopefully overachieve. But we don't know. I mean, you know, presently the current political climate and obviously the economy that depends on it to a certain extent is so uncertain. You know, I couldn't even predict what's going to happen next week rather than the end of the year. But the current trends, and obviously we're a four-year business, and you know we can pretty accurately reflect and predict our profits, certainly for the motor finance business, and almost certainly for the property bridging business. The current trends are very encouraging indeed, and I'm very confident as a result.
Good to get a quick update from you, Anthony. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Andrew.